Hey guys, this is Buzz Buzz, and here I have Mr. Yunus Yaşar straight from Gaziantep, and he is from the gastronomical center of Turkey. So food is his business, and there he is there, Mr. Yunus Yaşar. Yunus Yaşar, what are you doing, mate?
Şu anda biz çiğ köfte yapıyoruz.
Çiğ köfte. Çiğ köfte is raw köfte, raw meat. So, as you can see, the raw meat is in there. And what else, Yunus? You tell me.
Evet, ince bulgur.
Bulgur.
Isot.
Isot, which is black pepper.
Ondan sonra soğan.
Onion.
Limon.
Lemon.
Salça.
Tomato paste.
Acı biber salçası.
Oh, sorry, pepper paste.
Yoğurt.
Yogurt.
Buz.
Ice.
Domates.
Tomato.
Maydanoz ve en sonda et ve yağ.
And parsley, and later on we're gonna add the meat, and this is not gonna be cooked, it's gonna be raw, right? Yunus?
Pişmeyecek, elle sürtüne sürtüne.
By hand, by rubbing it, kneading it, he's gonna cook the meat. So basically we're gonna have raw meat. Let's go, Mr. Yunus.
Tamam abi. Şimdi başlıyorum.
Alright. And that's how he kneads it. He kneads it like that. And this is a process, like this isn't a short process.
Bu leğen de bunun için özel yapılmış tırtıklı köfte leğeni.
And this is a special pan.
Bu bulgurlar çok iyi bir şekilde eziliyor.
And this is a special pan, like it's specially made for this köfte. Köfte normally you cook it with mince and you can fry it, barbecue it, but this one's going to be raw. No cooking involved. Tomato. And it's all done by hand. And this is a dish that comes straight from Antep. And Yunus is from Antep. He's the king of Antep. Right, Yunus?
Thank you.
See?
Ben Gaziantep'liyim ve bu bizim yöresel yemeğimiz.
Traditional dish of Gaziantep, he's saying.
Biraz da kutsal bir yemek olduğu da söyleniyor.
Cultural dish.
Ta Hazreti İbrahim'e kadar dayandığını iddia edenler var.
Wow, Prophet Ibrahim.
Evet. King. Kral Nemrut.
Yes, King Nemrut.
Kral Nemrut, Hazreti İbrahim'i yakmak için şehirdeki tüm odunları toplamış.
To burn Prophet Ibrahim, he collected all the wood.
Ondan sonra şehirde ateş yakacak odun kalmayınca yemek pişirememişler.
When there was no wood left to burn in the city.
Ve bir avcı bir geyik avlamış.
A hunter hunted a reindeer.
Ondan sonra Urfalı bir karısı da geyiğin o yağsız siyah etiyle bu bulguru birleştirmiş ve
and his wife,
başlamış birbirine sürtmeye.
His wife, because there was no food left and he couldn't cook because there was no wood to burn. So she, when her husband hunted the reindeer, the black meat of the reindeer and the bulgur together, she started rubbing it and produced this dish.
Ve bu şekilde çiğ köfte başlamış.
And this is how this çiğ köfte all started.
Tüm Orta Doğu kültüründe bu çiğ köfte vardır.
And Central Turkey, this çiğ köfte is very traditional. And let me say, Yunus is a good, very good friend of mine. And he made this çiğ köfte for me about a year ago or so. Nearly 2 years ago. And he's in town and I said, Yunus, you're not leaving until you make this köfte for me. And he's about to make it for me. And I'm gonna eat it all.
Ve bu yemek biraz zahmetli olduğu için yapması sadece saygıdeğer konuklara yapılır.
And because it's a dish that's not easily prepared and made, it's made for special guests. And I guess I am the special guest. Değil mi Yunus? Frank teacher, special
evet,
guest.
Evet, for Frank teacher.
Okay, for Frank teacher, very good.
Frank teacher çok saygıdeğer bir adam.
He's a special man. Okay Yunus, what's that?
Şimdi biraz yoğurt koyuyoruz. Özellikle bulgura su koymuyoruz ki bir anda şişmesin diye.
Okay.
So yoğurtla biraz daha özleştiriyoruz.
Okay,
yani
so
birbirlerine kaynaşıyorlar.
So he doesn't use water. The tomato that he used, the water off that is soaking the bulgur. And now he's using a little bit of yogurt And that's also going to soak the bulgur as well. So he mixes it with the yogurt. First the tomato, then the yogurt. And add a little bit more yogurt he just asked for. Chef Yunus, master chef from Antep. This chef we brought from Antep just for this.
Bir de yoğurtla yediğin zaman miden daha ağrımayacak.
Okay, so and because he's doing it with the yogurt, he's not gonna, it's gonna be softer in the stomach. This guy is a master.
Böyle biraz özleştirdikten sonra eti koyuyoruz.
So after a little bit of kneading, now comes time for the meat.
Bu et de özel bir et.
Raw, minced,
yağsız,
very,
sinirsiz.
Very low fat, no veins. It's got to be no fat.
Yağsız, sinirsiz ve en az iki defa çekilmiş.
And it's got to be, it's got to be minced. Go through the machine twice.
Daha eskiden kadınlar evde taşla eti ezip bu hale getirirlermiş tabi. Kıyma makinesi yokken.
In ancient times, before the mince machine was invented, the ladies used to mash the meat with rocks.
O yüzden çok zahmetli bir yemek.
Because that's the reason why it's a very a time-consuming dish and needs a lot of effort, energy.
Artık başlıyoruz.
And now starts the process, and he's using some ice.
Ve et bakteri üretmesin diye içine buz koyuyoruz.
So the meat doesn't create any bacteria. He uses
Çünkü
the ice.
Çünkü elimizin altında sürtünmeyle beraber ısınıyor.
Because
Isınmasın
it gets warm
diye.
As he's kneading it, it gets warm.
Soğuk tutmak için buz koyuyoruz. Hem bir
and,
de
and to keep it cool.
Bulgur da bir anda şişmemiş oluyor.
And to keep it cool, he uses the ice. And also the water in the ice gradually goes into the bulgur and not all at once. And Mr. Chef here gets
evet.
all sweaty, and so the sweat doesn't go in the köfte. We need to wipe his sweat. Otherwise, we'll have sweat köfte.
Bu arada karıma da çok teşekkür ediyorum.
And,
da...
and he's just thanking his partner for being a good assistant.
Terimi sildiği için.
So we're in the process, and it's looking like köfte, and it's kneading away. He's putting a bit of blood, sweat, and tears in this.
Denemek ister misin abi?
Well, he's asking me, do I want to try? Do I want to try? Yes, I want to try. Yunus, it's nice. It's a little bit spicy. But it's nice spicy. It's not burning. Okay, so the chef is still going away. What are you putting in there, Yunus?
%75'ini yoğurduktan sonra, yani göz kararı, içine bir miktar maydanoz koyuyoruz.
When you're three quarters through, you put some chopped parsley in there. And it adds a little bit of flavor and a little bit of color.
Eğer evinizde varsa yeşil soğan da koyabilirsiniz bununla beraber.
You can add spring onion in it as well. And he's just kneading away. And Yunus is a strong man, so no problem for Yunus. Chef Yunus, not just Yunus.
Thank you, buddy.
Gaziantep'li Chef Yunus.
Thank you, buddy. Chef from Gaziantep.
Chef from Gaziantep, yes.
Yes, thank you. Hashtag Gaziantep.
Hashtag Gaziantep.
Dünyanın gastronomi başkenti Gaziantep.
World's center of gastronomical extremes. Food. If you want food and you want to try Turkish food, you got to go to Gaziantep. So now, we just added some olive oil that's been heated up. And he's added it in there, as you can see. The olive oil's there and he's going to knead it with the olive oil. Zeytinyağı niye koyuyorsunuz?
Biraz daha parlasın, yemeği kolaylaştırsın.
So it's easier on the stomach. And it gives it a nice shine to the köfte.
Sonuçta çiğ et yiyeceğiz.
We're yani gonna eat raw meat. So to make it digest easier, he heats up a little bit of olive oil, like half a cup. And it's in there, and now he's gonna knead it with that as well. And this is the end product. Köfte, çiğ köfte or raw köfte, bit of lettuce, you wrap it in it and you're gonna eat it. And I am a happy, happy camp. And maybe just one more for the camera. Fuzzbuzz, signing out. Chee Köf there. Thanks to Yunus Yaşar, the man, the master chef from Antep. Appreciated. Cheers.